got here a transmission oil filter, and we're going to talk about why it does not make sense to spend any time, any money, or any effort whatsoever, for that matter, to go after it. This transmission right here, you're going to see this pan. Underneath it, we're going to find this baby. We're going to take it apart. We're going to show you what 350,000 kilometers of service, no transmission fluid service, no transmission change whatsoever, exactly what came out of the factories in here, 250,000 miles later. We're going to take it apart and show you what's in it so you can decide for yourself, where do I spend my money and where do I not? The basic premise that we've got here is that this is a filter. And what we're going to tell everybody is that no, this is not a filter. It's been mislabeled. What this is a strainer. So imagine you've got a screen door in the back of your house, you're living out in the country, you want to keep the mosquitoes out, but you got a chain link fence on that back screen door. And you're wondering, how are these mosquitoes getting in here? I've got a screen door, it's closed, the mosquitoes are still getting in. It's because the mesh is not small enough to keep the mosquitoes out. Same thing going on here. This is not a high micron mesh. This is just basically to get the big chunks out to make sure that it doesn't get sucked up in here. If you've got a gear tooth or some sort of heavy metal part that gets down into this, it gets up into the transmission, with the way this is rotating, if that gets in here, you have a failure where you're breaking the transmission case open. You go from a $1,000 repair to a $10,000 repair in a blink of an eye. So this is just to keep that big stuff, that big debris out. It's not filtering out sludge and varnish. I mean, if you look at an oil filter, we've got an oil system that's under high pressure. We're cranking 40, 50, 60, 100 PSI, whatever it is, down through that filter with a high micron porosity in it. So if there's anything in that oil, it's going to be picked up, it's going to be filtered out, and fresh, clean oil is going to be squeezed out the other side. In the event that that filter gets so plugged, there's a bypass mechanism in there because you can't run your engine without oil. You had an oil deprivation event. Guess what? Motor, it doesn't work. It seizes up. It stops. So the oil filter is there to get everything out. In the event that it gets plugged, there's a bypass that lets you get a few extra kilometers, a few extra miles, whatever it is, to get that oil changed. But it's there to get the debris out. Here in a transmission, it's more like an air filter. It's like it's on the suction side, it's on the pickup side here. So when you're driving down the road, you've got leaves, you've got debris, you're driving around a gravel road, you got dust. That air filter is there to get that dust out so it doesn't go in. But where does that dust, where are the leaves, where does all that stuff come from in here? This is a sealed system. There is no debris floating around here. The only thing that we've really got is the clutch material that's breaking up. And guess what? This J-link fence will not catch the clutch debris. It flows through it. It goes through it all the time. It doesn't pack up and load up and load up until the pipe where it gets plugged. It just flows through it. And if you've got metal shavings in here, you either got a problem where the transmission isn't working properly, or you've got a small amount of debris or glitter in here. That's not enough to stop the oil from going through here. So going to get this as a point of service, waste of time. So now we're going to put the proof right here. We're going to get the rubber on the road. We're going to go in here and have a look. We've got one of our fantastic technicians over here, John. We're going to get this pan off. We're going to pull out this thing in service and we're going to get a look. Let's go see.
There it is.
Okay, here we are. We're moving forward with this. You see, we've got the oil pan off. We got the, actually this is the oil pan or the oil filter that we're going to make our example with. And you can see inside the pickup area how this one's nice and black, and we're hoping and we're excited that's going to show us something great. That's the new one. You can see how that's nice and clean. And the point that we're trying to make here is that there's going to be nothing of any consequence in that oil filter. It's amazing how it works. Bottom of this oil pan, there is a little magnet here. You'll see, I drag a paper towel over top of it. You'll see a little bit of dark gray material here. That's sort of like the, it's metallic for sure because it's being picked up, but really not something that's going to be caught in the oil filter, likely to plug it up. So again, it's this little magnet's doing its job. It's separating like the fine metallics, and nothing is really getting up in the transmission. So basically, taking a look at the bottom of valve body here, you see a transmission, 350, 400,000 kilometers, 250, 300,000 miles of service, no actual transmission fluid service change on this thing. It's still pretty remarkably clean, actually. So let's get into it. That's what we're going to do now, is we're going to cut this baby open, and we're going to see what we've got inside here.
You can separate it apart and get right into that sump, and I think we can.
As you can see, we're making some great progress here. We've got oil pan down, we've got our oil filter, or transmission fluid filter, cut open here, we can see it. And when we look at a new one from this point of view, it looks like there's just material or the oil flowing through a filter medium picking up. But when we get it apart here, what we can actually see is that this is more of a bag. It's more of a containment bag is what I'm trying to argue here. So what it looks like, this is the tube from my glass case right here. So I got my glasses, I wear around, I put my glasses in here to keep them from being scratched. That's what this thing here is. This filter media here is more like a bag. So it's got maximum surface area. The oil is picked up through here. There's no pressure at this point. This is 100% flow, not a pressure point in this at all. If it's even got -2, -3 PSI here to suck up through, that's way too much. This is working at basically zero pressure, 100% flow. It's flowing into this section here and under it here, and it's actually coming out before it heads up to the pump through this material. So maximum surface area is flowing through, not on just this side, but on the other side. You can see these ridges that are in here that keep this filter media from being sort of pressed occlusively up against the plastic component here. So this bag is 100% flow. What we're going to do now is we're going to cut this open so we can see what the inside, because this is the outside, this is the flow in this direction. We're going to get the inside of this filter media. We're going to have a look at it, and we're going to see what's on it and what this thing does. Okay, here we are. We're continuing with our grand experiment here. We've got our transmission pan down. We've got the transmission fluid filter out. We've got the filter media here exposed. We've cut back so we can see the bottom of this filter media. Again, with huge, huge mileage on this vehicle and absolutely no service. This is a landscaping pickup truck that came in that was regularly pulling heavy weight behind it. Transmission here was in full service all the time, and this is what we're getting. So what we're going to suggest to you is that this fluid filter here is just as porous and just as effective as it was the day it was installed. There is no huge chunks of metal in here. You can see a little bit of glitter as we move the light around in here. You pick up a little bit of glitter. There's a little bit of clutch material. I'm feeling a little bit of grittiness here in my fingers, but not really anything of any significance. So we're still getting the same amount of flow through this filter media that we got when it was brand new. So the suggestion that I have here for everybody is that this is more of a containment bag. And it comes back to what we're saying here. If there's a sort of a big failure in the transmission, and somehow in the bottom of this pan, we get big chunks of metal from gear teeth, planetary gears, sun gears, whatever it is, little pieces that are breaking off, even the teeth that are on the bottom of those clutch rings. If they get down in here, they get picked up, they get caught here, it's not gonna pack this solid. We're still gonna get flow. But what it's going to do is it's going to prevent that material from getting back up in here and getting into some huge pressure point and causing a catastrophic failure. If we get into this thing where the transmission case itself is exploding, that is unbelievably expensive compared to doing clutches or a typical transmission service in worst case scenario. So here it is. I think this should prove pretty much conclusively that, you know, this is, I don't know what you're thinking. John, what do you think of that?
Well, yeah.
Is that surprising?
Yeah, it's pretty clean for the mileage.
It's pretty clean.
Sure.
It's pretty clean. And this is what we're seeing on a regular basis. So we hear all you transmission guys out there saying, fluid filter. Well, you know what? Down here, we're not seeing it. And I guess the suggestion that we're going to make to everybody is, like, why would you go after this? Right? I mean, I understand there's a mentality. I can service my vehicle. I know how to maintain my vehicle. I'm going to put a fresh filter in my transmission, make sure my car goes longer or further or whatever the motives are. But the risk of that, particularly if you do it yourself or you're under the car's up on jack spans, you're gonna get down in here and you're gonna start wrenching on these things and you're gonna try to take these fasteners out. You get one stripped fastener, one snapped off bolt, you're into a world of hurt. And it's all to go get something that doesn't need to be done. It just doesn't need to be done. Now, a drying and fill, a drop in the pan to get the fluid out, that's a little different story, because the one thing that you can see in here that sort of stands out is there is no drain plug in here. So dropping this pan for the purposes of going to get, you know, the fluid out of the pan, well, then you're into something that may or may not make more sense depending on how you look at it. We have a transmission fluid flush machine. You know, those machines aren't cheap. They're $15,000-$20,000 to get a machine. There's other ways to get the fluid out there. You can break the fluid line, the transmission line at the return line coming out of the cooler. You can get it somewhere there. You get 4 or 5 liters out. Somehow you run it, get it out, close it, fit it back together, and then get some fluid back in. There's other ways of doing it. But getting this apart, getting this gasket, I mean, if there's a leak and you got to get it down because you've got a leak, that's another thing. It has to be done. But taking this down for the purpose of getting to this, our suggestion is, doesn't make a whole lot of sense. I mean, you can see worst case scenario, can't think of a higher demand than this truck was in. And you know what, there is no point in going after this thing. So if you're gonna get a transmission service, great idea. Every 30, 40,000 miles, for sure. 50,000 kilometers, you're getting a transmission service and you're getting the fluid out. You are never, ever gonna have problems. That thing's gonna run 100, I can even make the guess that it'll get up over 500,000 miles, pretty much guaranteed, I would think, if you're changing your fluid every 50,000 or so kilometers or miles. Point here, don't waste your money. So that's what we have to say today. We've talked about unbelievable importance of getting this fluid changed on a regular basis. Unbelievably important to make sure that the transmission lasts as long as possible. And that is how you do it. Good, clean fluid. We've got all kinds of technicians out there. We know we've got all kinds of shop owners and service advisors' opinion. We got do-it-yourselfers, all kinds of opinions. And both John and I are dying to hear what all you folks think about this. I know what we're saying here is a little controversial, that you don't need to do this. Not everyone's going to agree with us. This is our point of view. This is what we're showing you. But both John and I, dying to hear what you have to say. Go ahead, light up that comment box, and let's get a conversation going. Until the next time, Steve at the Auto Station.